Our second traversal algorithm is the depth first search, or DFS. This one you should really remember and try to understand. So it is a little bit simpler as the BFS. The idea is that we recursively visit nodes from the starting node. So we again have to remember if we visited a node or not, so we use our markers again, and we have to pass the distance as an argument here. So there are different ways of doing it. What I do in this case is I put the marker into the node data structure, which is a way to deal with this information for our list graph implementation. So let's have a look at the possible traversal order in this graph. So when we start at 1, we can go to 2, we can go to 3. Now we have to backtrack to 2, to 1, then we go to 4. We try to explore as deep as possible in the first instance, and if we can't do it, we backtrack. So let's have a look how this looks like in our implementation. So we have our wrapper function here, where we take a graph and a start node, and we take an observer again, a function that will be called with the distance, but also with the node information. Here I took the full node and not just the character that it consists of. So first what we need to do is we set all the markers to false. So we visited no node, therefore we use our linked information about the graph. So we take this graph data structure and iterate over it, over all the nodes in this list of the graph, and set the marker to false. Now we start with our depth first search. So if the node has a marker, we are done because we visited the node already. Otherwise, we set the marker to true, then we call the observer, and now all we need to do is we have to traverse all the outgoing edges of this node and basically call recursively our DFS again, but with a distance of plus 1. So here's now our example graph again, and an implementation where we use our newly defined DFS. Have a look what it does when we use start from node A or node D, which is here. What could DFS print? Pause now the video and I will reveal the answer in a minute. Welcome back. So what does DFS print in the two examples? So here we print the distance and we print the character. That's the first thing to spot here in the graph printer. And when we start at node A, well, the DFS could first iterate to the dot, for example, and then to C. And then it has to track back to node A, because from C there is no connection to B. And from A we traverse to B, but from B we cannot traverse to C because C has already the marker set to be true. When we start from node D, one potential order could be as follows. From D, we go to A, we go to B, we go to C, and now we actually visited all the nodes and we are done.